The government of Saudi Arabia is thinking about what does government look like in the 21st century in terms of delivery to citizens and the private sector, and they have implemented that. Now, the city itself is based on several components. One is a port that, in my mind, will change the logistics map globally. The trade routes will change, the stoppages, etc., and will have a very positive impact on transportation costs over the long term. Will be one of the largest 10 ports in the world, and the first phase is going to be opened end of next year. It will have a logistics backend to it. The second is the industrial zone, which is focused on what we can do best, which is energy intensive industries. We're trying to attract as many of those. We have a very competitive advantage. The third really is tourism. And we understand we can't compete with Paris, Dubai, and New York, but we are still the 17th most visited country in the world because of the Hajj and Umrah for Muslims. So we're trying to address how can we serve these visitors in a more elaborate way and provide them with tourism opportunities around their religious experience. And then there's housing. The population of the kingdom is 65% under 30. We need to build 4 million housing units over the next 20 years. So we need housing. And so we're set up for that. And if we get 10% of that market, we'll build up the city end to end by 2030. We're targeting 2 million people. It's the size physically of Washington, D.C. The port will be one of the largest 10 ports in the world. So it is a pretty sizable undertaking. You often hear about these projects that they're nice in concept, but they never work on the ground. We've been able to attract more than 40 international and local industrial tenants to date, which tells us we have something proper to offer. And then we are offering expansion opportunities for the local players, local industry. So it's a very exciting time. The city is coming to life next year with the port opening, and a lot of these industries are ready. We have schools, we have hotels, etc. We've gone through the setup phase of does it work? Is there an economic basis for it? Does it work on a private sector basis? What's the role of the government in the private sector? That's done. And now it's about execution. But as I look forward over the next 6 to 8 years, it's more about can you implement that next great generation of systems thinking? You know, not applying small technological advances, but really systematically thinking about energy use, systematically thinking about water use, systematically thinking about data, and how you apply a systems thinking to these areas. I think this is very important. The second is we ourselves, because of the sustainability movement, has changed the planning world. If you look at the master plan 6 years ago, it's already outdated from what you would build today. So we are continuously revising that. For example, right now we're doing a lot less concrete and much more natural, eco-friendly, ecologically friendly, if you will, development, which is very important, I think, for sustainability and the resilience of the city over the long term. So we're thinking and we're trying to think and stay ahead, because a lot of things are changing, if you will, a lot of these ideas and concepts. A lot of cities, when they're developed by the government, they're developed with the right framework in mind. They bring in the best consultants, they think about what they want to do with these cities and have a very clear value proposition. The problem with it when government does it is it's very hard to change. So with us being private sector, we get this feedback. I get it every 3 months because we're publicly listed. If I'm doing a good job and our products work, people buy them, we're willing to pay for them, and hence you know, we get positive incentive to do more of them. When they don't, we know about it very quickly. So that has allowed us to be much more flexible in terms of our what we're doing, our master plan, our products, lowering the cost of some products, doing more in some areas, and driving that forward. So it's important not to have only a top-down. That's critical, because that's master planning, ultimately, is top-down. But to really also have a bottoms-up, a way to get feedback into the system. Cities typically do give that feedback when they elect mayors. But that happens every 4 to 6 years. It's interesting, our model now is a quarterly model.